Okay, so my name is Richard Doherty and I am Senior Director for Solution Marketing at Workday. And my background is very much from HR technology. So I've worked in HR tech for the last 20 years. I'm based in London at the moment, obviously working from home. Just before I start the presentation, let me just bring your attention to our safe harbor statement. If I make any forward-looking statements, please keep in mind that the future is uncertain and plans can change. I've just got a couple of slides to introduce Workday, but I'm not sure I actually need to do that because I've been listening to the conference this afternoon, and I've seen three great Workday customers giving presentations or on a panel. So, but just very briefly, Workday, we are a native cloud solution provider for enterprises. We provide solutions for financial management, human capital management, spend management, analytics and benchmarking, and finally for business planning, covering both financial planning and workforce planning. Sort of a complete platform for your digital core, if you like, as a business. We've been around for 15 years now, and the company's been very successful. We have customers, about 3,500 customers spread around the world using Workday in 170 countries. And there you can see some logos of a number of customers. And the thing is, they're all in different vertical industries, but they're all using this exact same solution. They're on the same version. It's just configured in different ways. Okay, so that's enough about Workday. Let me just stop there. Okay, great. So why does employee experience matter? Well, if you were to go into Google and do a search on employee experience, please don't do that now. I don't want to lose you. But if you were to do that, you would be hit with lots of different research and statistics that you could use to build a business case to invest in employee experience. You know, depending upon where you look, it will help you drive a more profitable organization. It will drive a good employee experience, will drive organizational success. It will help you retain employees longer, and so on and so on. There are so many reasons why the employee experience is essential. Now, we've been talking about employee experience for a few years, but it's become even more important now. Clearly, lots of people have gone from working in offices where they would be seeing their colleagues on a daily basis, they would be going into meeting rooms, face-to-face collaboration, innovating, sharing ideas, interacting, you know, directly with their managers, to now, you know, many of us working from home and have been working from home for a number of months, in a study, in a spare bedroom, sitting at the kitchen table on our own, perhaps feeling a little bit lonely, perhaps concerned about your role, perhaps having to pick up new skills because your job has changed. And that can lead to, you know, an impact on productivity or on engagement. So the employee experience is even more important now, given this world that we're currently living in. Now, I'd just like to look at or consider employee experience within what we see is a very changing world of talent and talent management and how our organizations look at talent. So, you know, for the first time in history, you know, we've got five generations working side by side in the workforce with very sort of different these generations have been formed in very different ways, educated differently, grown up in very different worlds. We have more data than we've ever had before on the workforce. And, you know, those leading companies, those innovative companies, those companies that are doing well are able to leverage that data for valuable people insight that helps shape their people strategies. Internal mobility has become incredibly important, particularly now, because organizations need to become more agile. You have this need to shift people around in your organization to work on specific business objectives or specific goals, and you can't rely on a rigid hierarchy anymore. I think, you know, the agile way of working that ING were talking about earlier, you know, networks of teams, how do you create those teams rapidly? How do you match workers to work? And then finally, we see the emergence of skills as being at the core of successful HR strategies moving forward. You need to understand the skills of your workforce, and you can leverage those skills in many different ways to help you accelerate internal mobility, generate more insight from people analytics, to and then also to drive a very positive employee experience. Now, when we look at employee experience, it was interesting earlier on, Thomas from Lego was talking about the employee experience and how they were defining their personas and trying to map out, you know, the experience that they want to provide for their employees. And, you know, I would contend that, yes, definitely you start with personas, but you know what? We're all different. We all are at different stages of our career. We've got, you know, different priorities, different interests, different skills, and so on and so forth. So therefore, don't we all deserve to have an experience that understands us? It understands us as a person, as an employee, as an individual, and it surfaces an experience to us that matches that those criteria. So therefore, we will engage as an employee. We will engage with that experience because it makes sense to us. It understands us. And then on top of that, and again, I've heard this phrase used a couple of times already today. You know, there are certain moments that matter in an employee's time with your organization. And there is some examples on the screen there of moments that matter. But a good example is someone who is an individual contributor is promoted to become a people leader. That is a big transition. It's a big change. And we need to help employees who are going through that transition by providing them with a very targeted employee experience that seeks to raise them up and help them in that transition. Other transitions are things like perhaps, you know, which are typically handled very badly, I think, in organizations. Things like when a female member of staff returns from maternity leave. That's a difficult transition. So we need to target that employee with an employee experience that helps them through that transition. Now, at Workday, you know, for our own employees, we are very focused on trying to deliver an outstanding employee experience because we want to be a great place to work. And also working with our customers, we can see that they are all also heavily focusing on the employee experience, probably one of the reasons why they've invested in Workday. And through those interactions on our own work, we're building up a philosophy and a framework around, you know, designing and building out effective employee experiences. And the key thing here is, it may seem obvious, but, you know, at the very core of everything to do with the employee experience, you need to put the employee. You need to be looking at the experience from the perspective of the employee. So, you know, and this is this concept is design thinking. And if you've been involved in sort of designing customer experience journeys or customer journeys, it's the same idea. So we put the employee at the center. Then the first thing that we need to do is we need to generate some context, if you like, around that employee. We need to understand what motivates them. We need to understand what their aspirations are. We need to understand what's important to them. And by painting that picture of the employee, you know, we can then start thinking about a specific employee experience for that employee. Once you've understand the context, we then need to think about what are the different types of content that we can surface to that employee that they're going to find useful, that are perhaps going to make them more productive or enable them to achieve, you know, sort of develop themselves and achieve their potential. And I will talk about it in a minute, but you've got lots of different types of content that you have available to you that you can start pushing to the employees. And then finally, so once we understand the employee, we've painted this picture of the employee and we've got content, we can then combine those two elements together to build out a specific experience for that employee to help them set their course, if you like, and so to help them develop. Because again, I think it was Spotify we're talking about in terms of career development, it's up to the employee now. You know, no one in the organization is sitting there and managing their career for them. It's up to you. And the employee experience can help them on that journey, help them provide structure, help them provide with content that will help them manage their own careers. And there are, you know, as we design an employee experience, we need to think, well, there's going to be certain elements that we want to push to the employee. We want to provide nudges to remind them to do things. And maybe certain types of learning activity, you know, to develop a certain skill that we know they need. But we'll also want to have content in there that they can discover themselves, so that they are motivated, they're engaged, they're going into, say, a system to find that nugget, to find out information about, well, how do I go and work in another country for my employer? How do I get a promotion? So on and so forth. So you need to provide a way for them to do that. And then also, you know, as an organization, there'll be certain things that we want to include in that employee experience, certain content that we want to push. And then also we need to balance that with the fact that there's certain things that the individual is going to be interested in. And we need to get that balance right to keep both sides of the coin, if you like, happy. So let's look at those different circles there. And let's think about the context. So what kind of information do you need to gather to understand your employees? So things like their skills, what skills have they got? What skills are they interested in developing? What are their career aspirations? How well are they performing? What kind of feedback are you getting from other employees about them? Do they have a mentor? And so on and so on. So you can gather all that data together to paint this picture of an employee so that we can start personalizing the experience. And then additionally, we need some way, and this needs to be in an automated manner. Pretty much everything I'm talking about needs to be automated. Otherwise, this targeted employee experience, it won't scale up. You know, if you have 100 employees, yeah, maybe you can do it. When you have a few hundred employees, 1,000 employees, 10,000, 50,000, you have no chance of doing that. So you need to automate this. So we need some way of, in an automated manner, identifying when is an employee at a point in time in their life cycle with you, when are they at a moment that matters? So they've just been promoted, they're going on maternity leave, they're returning from maternity leave, they've just been expatriated, and so on and so on. You need a way to be able to identify that and trigger that targeted employee experience that I talked about. Now, from a content perspective, here's some examples of content that you can target employees with. And what we need to do now within HR systems is follow the sort of our favorite e-commerce sites or our favorite apps on our phone that know us as individuals and start making suggestions to us. That's exactly what we need to do in our HR systems. We need to be suggesting to employees, look, have you thought about completing this learning course? Because it's going to help you pick up this skill, which will give you the opportunity perhaps to apply for this job or this work opportunity within the organization. So sort of learning opportunities, job opportunities, perhaps internal projects, surface up insights to them, give them ready access to knowledge base articles around people policies and so on and so forth. Make it easy for them to find the information that they need. And ideally, they shouldn't have to jump around, multiple different systems trying to find the information. They should be able to go to one place. And then by stacking up this content, effectively, we're providing each employee with the content that will really fundamentally allow them to achieve their potential. And that's good for them, and it's good for us as an organization. And that final part about helping setting a course for them, which is combining those different pieces of content which you've decided are relevant for that employee based upon the context of how we understand that employee. And there are various techniques that you can use to get them engaged in that experience. The nudges, the alerts, insights, popping up interesting data about how the organization is functioning, what skills are in demand, for instance. That may drive me to actually think, well, I need to do a learning course on this, on such and such a skill, because it's in demand in my organization, for instance. So the combination of those three elements will allow you, we believe, to design an outstanding employee experience. Now, you won't really be able to do any of that without the right technology, right? So this is a modern employee experience. It's not the whole thing, obviously. Your employee experience is also to do with the culture, the values of your organization, and so on and so forth. But when we look at it from a talent experience, you need to have the right technology in place to enable the experiences that have been talked about in a personalized manner. Now, it's all the one message I think I would like you to take away from this 15-minute presentation is that it's all about the data. As we saw, we started with the employee and we started building the context. So you need to have lots and lots of data on the employee so you can build a picture of them, so you can create this relevant experience that's going to engage them, it's going to help them develop, it's going to help them be more productive. But we know that data is a challenge. You may have different HR systems in different countries. You may have in one country a core system, core HR system, different payroll system, talent systems, learning systems, all different, data spread all over the place. That's going to be a major roadblock for your organization to provide that outstanding employee experience. So, you know, I think we're seeing a lot of this at the moment. So for instance, one of our biggest customers went live in the last couple of months. So Walmart, the very big retailer, they went live with Workday for 1.7 million employees worldwide. They rationalized their HR systems landscape. Now one version of the truth, they have that data all in one place. So if Walmart can do it, then anyone can do it, right? So it's about rationalizing your system landscape and trying to strip down to the minimum number of systems as possible so that you have that data that I've been talking about that will drive that employee experience. And then finally, you know, AstraZeneca here, I mean, forget about that it's Workday, but you know what they're saying is, you know, the latest technology is enabling them to harness the power of big data. It's providing them with invaluable insights about their people, and they're seeing exceptional engagement and adoption of their HR system because of the data. And it's been truly transformational for them. So on that note, just like to thank you very much for listening to me this afternoon, and wish you a good rest of the day. Thank you, and back to you.